Welcome with SwissTrader. I present here the opening range oriented strategy, Oro. Oro means gold in Italian, and it's a golden strategy. And we'll first look at the last Friday's prices. On Thursday, we have at the evening we have a symmetrical triangle, and at 5:50, about 10, 6 minus 5 in the morning, Trump said that he will communicate with China about war, about trade war, and the price rose extremely. And now I traded here short, and it went even higher, and this was an error because I didn't look where the opening range here in red, the first hour, the dimensions of the first hourly candle, where it lies in. And if we look at this, we have here maybe a impulsive wave. 1, 2, 3 until here. Here the fourth wave, and here the fifth wave. And therefore, this would have been predictable that it goes even higher. And after this fifth wave, we have maybe a A, B, C somehow. And afterwards we love, we went down. I shorted here, and I set out, it's about 100 points. And only in the afternoon I was in win position. And now we have to look at other indicators too. I have here the 3 minute time frame. It's a bit short, but we see some details. First, Ichimoku. Here we have a very large green cloud, which supposes a big support, a resistance below, and therefore we see that we don't break. There are only many false breakout, about 4 or 5, and we have the Chikuspan, the green line. It's always above the price, not in the price. That means it's a strong uptrend. And we have here the ADX, first extremely strong, then here it's weak, and this supposes a weak downward signal, a downward trend, weak upward trend, and only here begins the red zone. And the clue is to look at everything, and we see here this up thrust here. It was in an environment with few volume. My assumption in the morning was more or less right, because we have an uptrust in a low volume area, and it would be sold if there is big volume. But it was only sold here with big volume, when the US, after the US opening, there was the right sell-off, and we stayed the whole morning until 11 o'clock. We stayed in this opening range. Let's try to look at another day. On Thursday, the day before was a no move day. We hardly left the opening range, and we seem to have somehow a first impulse wave here. 1, 2, 3, and yes, it's from this perspective, it's hard to say that it will be a break above. Maybe, yes, we have here, we never went under the lower opening range here in the previous day, and that suggests that the probability that we have that we have no false breakout to above is larger. And here we have a higher high, we just have a first impulse wave. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is we have here a we could project this opening range 3 times. And we see it here. The ADX crosses above here, and we can hold until here. And it went. There was a small reversal, and there it is again, positive. In general, the ADX minus and plus is faster than, for example, a cross of the Gichun and Tenkan. It is hardly visible. Maybe I have to. The cross is of Tenkan Kinchun was about here. Maybe I will. I'll make this. This a bit fatter. Do we see it better? There are too many lines, and we have still in the point of control is always it's important too. We will make a playback here. And maybe we will see it better. Maybe this is a very let's make a playback from here somewhere. Yes, we see here maybe a ascending triangle with higher lows, and we will start the journey from here, maybe from here. Now we are below the opening range, we have higher highs. we are under the VWAP, under the SMA 200, and point of control here, it wanders to, and we fell back to the pre-day's opening range, the Ichimoku. Ah yes, we see this. Now we have an upcross in the Ichimoku and an upcross in DI minus and DI plus here. We are still below the cloud but above the VWAP. Maybe we'll make a double button here, bottom. And if we see this, I want to know what is the behavior of the next day. Bit faster. So we have 9 o'clock in the evening. Now we are coming back to the opening range. Maybe we can identify an impulse wave. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3rd wave. Now we will raise. This opening range is already painted. Now I will slow it down. I will say we have no false breakout here because we have here 1, 2, maybe 3. Maybe this will be the fourth wave, but it won't go under here. Let's see. And maybe we will even climb higher. I'm not sure if we have a false breakout here because this wave run already very far. I rather would say we will go back down and we'll go back up. That's the last day of the month, the 31. Now we come back, yes. But I suppose we don't have a false breakout here. It's not so sure. Yes, we have a false breakout, yes. As I said, now we are going up. We could have traded here from here to here. And It's very important to look at the pre-day's history. And it might be well be that we today we don't go very far, maybe one projection. And this would be the fifth wave. It should not be so strong anymore. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think, I wonder if we have still a projection. I don't think so. There will be no movement during the day, maybe. What we see, we are still above the cloud. But now we plunge beyond the Tenkan-sen. But the cloud holds. And now maybe we have here A, B, C somehow. Now we have 10:30. Normally we have a change in direction at 10:30. And now it's consolidating. Now I wonder if the opening range is left. I don't think it is left yet. In regard of the trade, we could have traded this direction. Maybe this one. Here we have A, B, C again. And now I think we will, I don't know if we will go over the VWAP. Does not seem so. Now we go over the VWAP. But we are still in the opening range. There is not much movement. We have again no breakout below, even a higher high here, a higher low. But we have no breakout over here either. Now what the time? It's still 12:30. Maybe we have still a rise until 1 o'clock. in the afternoon we will go down again. We could make a long trade with the stop loss over here because we have these higher lows. But it's only 2 o'clock in the afternoon when US opens. Everything is else. Maybe we kill our long here. Yes, and now we just move about around the VWAP. There are only very short time trades. Let's look at the opening. Now the opening is soon here. Winter time divergence. We open already at 2 o'clock, 2:30. It rises again, no. But normally in the last few days we went down in the afternoon after opening. Now we have the opening, yes. We continue the rise. One could look at this one, two, three, four, five, A, B, C, and here new wave, one, two, three, four, five, maybe. Now we stay over the range. We could go here long, maybe to the range projection. Maybe you have here a double top. Now we are poorly long. Tenkan Kichun cross, where is it? Somewhere here. It's 4 o'clock. Still are rising, but we have big pullbacks to the VWAP. Now we are rising. VWAP is a good divider between short and long day. Yes, now we are rising very fast. It's not very easy to make a prognosis of the next day or on the next day's opening range, but we still see that the opening range is very significant. Here we are just in the range of the opening range. Now we bounce off the SMA 200. We have indecisiveness here, quite red. Undecidedness. Double button with a higher low. Maybe we could go long here. Oh no, Tenkan and Kichun are negative here. We are below the cloud. Right? Maybe it's not yet long. Now we cross up Tenkan Kichun. We get green here. We have here triple bottom. Maybe we will trade long a rebound to this resistance here. We have here a the resistance of the cloud. And here we have the VWAP and the SMA200 together. This must be a very good support. We could go long and have the stop loss below here, because we can be more or less sure that the price won't fall down here. Just leave this so we will see what happens. We have here many supports, the point of control, VWAP and SMA200. Big, and here the cloud is to a support. So we will see if this support holds. It needs a lot of passion, so now it turns to the red. But this is really a good support. 1, 2, 3. Let's look, I make it a bit faster. Support holds. Oh, now he breaks through. That would have been a bad trade. And now we have the 1st of November, and usually in the beginning of the month there are flows into the market. Oh, it runs at very early. We have break up to the upper side here. Well, yes, I wanted to show you how the opening range is related to the big picture. Here the opening range is we start positive and we have a doji, it's a bit undecisionness, and we have a higher low and therefore a breakout here, and I think it's very important to look at the larger environment. Let's look at the next day again. Situation we are bound to the point of control. It's a resistance. Maybe we will overcome this resistance. Now we have soon the next morning. What we see here is, yeah, maybe some trail, but it the direction of the triangle outbreak is not clear. Now here, what have we? Do we have here? It looks like an impulse wave. One, two, maybe it's the third wave. Maybe we'll go up to tomorrow. And we got a consolidation overnight. Oh no, not yet. It's still the previous day. Now what do we have? Some one. Oh yes, we break up. Ah yes, this was this Friday, the last Friday. We have here the news and with maybe one, two, three, this is the third wave, and we will even go far up to the fifth wave about here, and we consolidate only in the morning. Well, that was it. Important is the opening range to see it where it lies in the big movements, to have the confluences of maybe Chikuspan, Tenkan-sen, Kyun-sen. Here we have a cross up and ADX, 8 day plus and day minus. We have here a cross up and we still look at a point of control, VWAP and SMA, simple moving average 200. Well, that was it. This was the opening range oriented strategy, not breakout. Breakouts don't happen so often in these times. Very volatile times, and just orient at the opening range, but don't trade the breakouts or breakdowns. Well, thank you for your interest, and bye with SwissTrader.